In today's episode, we're going to jump into using hotwire rails, which gives you these methods in your model. And the end result is you can update a object and it'll update another view. So for another user, which is really cool. So DHH has just released hotwire, which is a collection of JavaScript libraries, including something called Turbo, Stimulus, and Strada, which allows us to send HTML over the wire to make web pages feel really real time. What's pretty awesome is you can actually go and install Hotwire Rails right now and start using it. We're going to use it in this video to make a web page do real time updates. Because we're going to be using WebSockets today, we need Redis running locally. I normally use the Docker Rails template to get me started, and this is just a quick repo where you can click use template or clone down it locally, and you can use Docker Composers to turn it on. And that means I'm going to have Docker running, which is going to be quite fun. We're also going to be using some pretty undocumented stuff today, so it's likely to change. You can kind of find what I'm working on in the Hotwired and Turbo Rails repo, and this is kind of what the documentation will look like. So I'm pretty excited to show this to you. We're going to start by adding Hotwire Rails to our existing Rails application. So I'm going to take the gem name, and I'm going to go into my terminal here. I've already got bash running within my container because we've got to do everything with Docker. So I'm going to do bundle add hotwire rails. And this will just add the gem to our gem file, install it within our container, and all that other loveliness. Cool. So now if I do rails on its own, we're going to get a new command we can run. And you can see it here, it's called hotwire install. So I'm going to run rails hotwire install. Cool. Let's have a quick look at what it's just changed. So we've got the layout application. So we can see it's added these three lines in. So it's doing something in the head each time. It's got turbo include tags and stimulus include tags. So that's quite exciting. I'm not sure what they'll do, but whatever. It's changed our manifest, which it looks like it's done that so these things are pure work, I imagine. It's turned off asset debug mode. I'm guessing we can't have multiple files or something. It's turned off rack mini profiler. Yeah, it has. That's quite interesting. And then it's done a bundle. Cool. Okay, what else did it change? Anything else? Okay, it's only a few things. That's quite exciting. Let's see if our app still works. Okay, looks like we're going to have to quickly restart our app. Okay, that's kind of exciting. It looks like our design has just gone. What I'm going to do is to get that back is I'm going to go to the public file and just quickly delete the packs. Okay, and then quickly restart this again. There we go, much better. We're going to make it so every time someone updates one of these attributes, it's going to update for everyone viewing this page without them having to do anything. We're going to use two methods to achieve this. One is the turbo stream form method, which you can find in the Hotwire Turbo Rails repo under this place right now. And we're also going to use broadcast to, which is just a wrapper for these methods. This is a concern, which means it'll be automatically added to our application record class so we can just use it. Okay, so we're going to start by copying this turbo string from method. I'm going to go to my post index and I'm just going to chuck it in here. And we're going to use a key called posts. So what this means is the user is going to be subscribed to a stream called posts, and we're going to push data to that stream, and when the user receives it, something will happen. What you can do if you need to make it user specific is you could be like current user if you really wanted to, and then that'll kind of fix it to that user's current stream, which is quite exciting, but I won't cover that too much for now. And the next thing we're going to do, we're going to update our model, and we're going to add the method we saw in here. And I am just going to copy this out. We're just going to copy this first bit. So this method creates all these other methods, or calls all these other methods. And they all run after the commit. So that means when it's saved to the database and is then available to the workers, it will go and queue up a active job to go broadcast some HTML out on the particular stream, which in our case will be called posts, which is quite exciting. And you'll notice it's being passed in here by a proc. So we could just call all these and pass in the web post as the first argument. However, it's expecting a proc when we use this helper. So we're going to just pass in a key as the result. So let me show you, that'd be a bit easier. So we're going to call this post. So the argument is post, and we're just going to return the web posts. So that needs to match up with this, is what you need to know. Okay, so let's quickly see what this does. I'm going to open terminal. I can see it's going a little bit crazy already, but let's see what happens. If I was to just clear that off, edit this, and do, a sample title. Let's see what explodes. Okay, so you kind of knew this was coming. Here is the crux of this error. It says it passed off to the worker and said, hey, go render this. And then the worker was like, wait, what am I rendering? And it went and looked for posts underscore posts. So that doesn't exist. So we need to add that. So by default, this is going to render whatever is called when to partial path is called. So that's what you get when you do like post to partial path. So let me just show you that actually. Compare on RLC. So post equals post dot last. So thing we're working on to partial path. There you go. That's what it's called and gone. Okay, so what am I going to render? Go render this. So let's add that. Let's go in here and add that. Let's go .html.erb, because that's the file it's looking for. We want it to update this thing here, so we'll take that out. We'll put it in here. Cool. And we're also just going to do render posts, because as we all know, Rails sees a collection, calls to partial path on all of them, and just renders it out. It's pretty awesome. Oh yeah, let's give this a quick go. Where are we at now? Okay, looks like we could be doing something. Let's see if this can actually render something correctly now. Okay, that's exciting. Let's open two tabs. Let's see them side by side. Let's see if this actually works. So I think I've missed a step already. Okay, so that's the home page there. We're going to click edit, title, update posts. Ah, nothing happened. Let's have a little look-ski here. What's going on? Okay. We're going to look at this WebSocket. This is the WebSocket we're using to connect to. We can see there's some stuff going on there. Let's quickly edit this again. Let's say 22. Okay, we've got something. We can see in here, this is what's been sent, and it said, oops, said, go replace the target of post one with this HTML. Okay, so there's a problem here, because we don't have anything called post one on our page. So where's that actually coming from? Well, yeah, I can probably tell you pretty quickly. We need to have an ID called post one. And that is like the post and then the ID. The way this is generated is with DOM ID. So we're gonna do DOM ID post. Cool, so if I was to quickly go back to this homepage, we've now added a DOM ID onto that. So it's now going to look for this ID here and update it. So let's see if this works. Yeah, it just updated. That's pretty magical. And if I was to quickly do it again, just to show you how really quick it is. How fast that is. So updating the index page is quite cool, but it'd be more interesting if we could change the show page as well. And to do that, we're going to pass in a partial to that broadcast argument. The only annoying thing about this one is we can't use that nice little wrapper we had because we need to pass in like an extra argument on the end called partial. Instead, we have to drop down and actually call this method directly. So we're going to use the broadcast replace to. They actually had partial in their example here, so that's pretty awesome. So I'm going to quickly copy that. I'm going to go to the post quickly, and I'm going to do, I think it is after update commit. Let's just say update show view. I'm going to quickly make a private method. Oops. I'm going to call it update show view. I'm going to pass that in there. And these arguments aren't quite right. We're gonna just use the same. We're gonna use self as the first argument. So we're gonna broadcast to self, which means we're gonna broadcast to a stream, which has the same reference as the current object, which is quite exciting. And for the partial, we're gonna use post, and we're gonna do show. And then for the locals, I think we're just gonna have a post locale. Or post local anyway, and that'll be all good. All right, so we have this. We're gonna start by making this method. As I mentioned in here, we're gonna broadcast to self. So in this case, self is the post. So if we were just to do post, that'd be pretty good. And annoyingly, we need to use a partial here. We can't just call this show page directly. So we're gonna do render, post slash show, and we're gonna do post. I think that'll work. Okay, let's quickly add in this underscore show partial. Oops, shimmer.lb, there we go. And let's see how that goes. I think the only thing we're missing now is we need to quickly wrap this in a div with an ID where the DOM ID is the post. Looks pretty good. Nice. What have I done wrong here? Oh, forgot to close that off. Okay, cool. And because this at variable isn't available in this instance, there we go. Okay, perfect. Let's have a look what that looks like when we go to a show page quickly. Okay, that loads, that's good. So we go in here, we can see we've got the post ID 1. We can see with the network, let's refresh this again. You can see the cable's all connected and we have some messages coming in. Okay, great. So let's quickly update this. Huh, that just worked, that's quite cool. Can see the network chucked in, oops, in a channel, and it said, hey, replace post ID underscore one with that big old block of HTML. That's great, cool. So does this affect the homepage at all? That's what I'm kind of wondering. Close that off. So if I was to edit this again, go, that does not, that's really cool. You're probably wondering, how do I make new stuff just appear under here? So let's have a quick look. I'm going to show you how I managed to debug this earlier. So we can see the cable's connected here, and we've got a response. Let's quickly add a new post and give it some sample copy. So if I click create post, you can see there is an identifier message in here. Okay, so what we can see is there's a message that says turbo stream action append and the target is posts. So what it's doing there is it's looking for an element with the ID of posts. which is quite cool. So what we're going to do, we're going to go into here. That's our little thing there. We're just going to do id equals posts. And it will append a little attribute in there. So let's quickly refresh this page. And let's call this newer object. And be like, yeah. Right, this should just appear over here. Yeah, it did. So what it did is looked for that ID and appended that partial into it. So I'm really impressed with what Hotwire can offer, especially for this real-time stuff. This kind of DSL is generally what I've wanted in most of my apps. Like, I don't need anything ridiculously complicated. I do encourage you to kind of have a look at the code base, have a little peruse yourself, because there's a lot more to it than what I've just described and shown you. But I'm really excited for this to come to Rails and new projects to be using it. And I hope you are too. Please remember to give me a follow and a like. I always really appreciate those. And if you have any topics you're really interested in, drop them into the comments below and I will jump on them as soon as I can. Thank you for watching.